find a letter with them things. What do they wait for? The change. All the promise when they make. They're gonna be like say I think. Where the money, where the food. Everybody wants it. Since you know the tears are fed, we're not tired to go away. I see the bad way you be doing. I'm telling you, keep your ears. 97% of 5%. You're not being put like president. You're not being put like president. I take your office to the stage. All I want to do is to be better.
Don't scatter for your head, yo. Jesus.
Then do.
They change. Let me get my glasses. 1 sec. Improve. Yeah, let me get myself set. He's changing Ayawa. We don't do this suffer. Nigeria, my sister. Yawa. Nigeria. What did you change you?
So you can share this broadcast. Share it and invite others. More fire them. You see, we've told them that they fought to have the power. Now they have the power. They don't have control over it. They are now using the power to fight themselves. Everything Nigerians have been suffering from in the hands of the police, in the hands of the military, in the hands of all these security agencies, the people in government are now suffering it. That's how God can turn victory into something else for the criminals who never really mean well for Nigeria. Now, we'll talk. Police is harassing the number three man in Nigeria, Bukola Saraki. Bukola Saraki, the former MD, Managing Director, Societal General Bank. How many of you remember Societal General Bank? Yeah, they always talk about Societal General Bank. It was meant to be like a community bank that was meant to take care of the poor. You know, they give loans, small loans. So, but Societal General Bank, founded by the father of Bukola Saraki, Senator Bukola Saraki, Dr. Olusola Saraki. So he started the bank to help the poor. That was the concept. So they needed to capitalize, you know, to recapitalize or whatever they call it. So they approached rich Nigerians, including J.J. Okocha. J.J. Okocha also invested 1 million naira of that time, 1991. 1 million naira. So they took his money. And at the end of the day, the bank collapsed. And the people who put the money in the bank were never compensated, either by Nigeria or by Saraki family. So when the scandal will never go away, they started paying some people, including J.J. Okocha. So they paid J.J. Okocha his money. And I think it was Obasanjo that helped J.J. Okocha to get his money then. For those who remember the story, this is the story of Bukola Saraki. Bukola Saraki became the governor of Kwara State. And it was during the time when Muhammad Lawal, 1999, Muhammad Lawal, sponsored by Dr. Olusola Saraki at the time, in ANPP or APP, if you all remember the story. So eventually, Muhammad Lawal fell out with Dr. Olusola Saraki, the godfather of Ilorin politics, the man who has managed one way or the other to use religion to coward the people of Ilorin in particular. But here is the point. Sometimes the narrative out there is that Ilorin people worship Saraki family. No, they don't worship Saraki family. What happened is this. They have created a sort of cult followership in Ilorin that is very unique. You see, poverty is something that people always feel like when you don't have money or you are poor, it is because something someone somewhere put, what is it called? Put a curse on you not to be rich. Do you know what I mean? That poverty is something that someone must have caused you. No, poverty is something always orchestrated by the people in charge of your own affair. I mean, the government of your country. Saraki family managed over time to position themselves in the exact art of Ilorin politics, Kwara politics, so to say. And they used religion, like I said, they used that religion to make people, and you know, whatever message they want to give to the people through politics and the rest of that, they take it through religion. They send people to Mecca. In fact, it was like a visa free for Saraki family, especially Dr. Olusola Saraki, to the to Riyadh, the royal family in Saudi Arabia. They give him money every now and then for different charity programs in Ilorin and around Kwara, then including Yoruba land, building mosque and the rest of that. So this was like a family that God sent to them in Ilorin. Politically, they look up to them. Religiously, they look up to them. Not because they believe in them, but because religion says your leaders are appointed by God. And Saraki Oloye, Dr. Olusola Saraki, was adjudged to have been made their leader by providence and by God. And therefore, it could never be wrong. No matter what, whatever you try against them, they see it as you are trying to bring down a man that God purposely put in that place to help them pay their children's school fees, their aged their mothers who can't afford hospitals, that the Saraki families who are in charge of government have one way or the other siphoned the money, squandered the money, and eventually the people are now left with nothing. This is the story of Sarakis. In 8 years of being in government, Saraki was never held responsible for what happened in society, I mean, to society general. Nobody held him responsible, because the moment he could have been probably prosecuted, was when he became governor. And the moment he became governor, he earned immunity and used the instrument of office, both federal and state and wherever, foreign, wherever, to bury that. Then the new phase of running Kwara State bankrupt began. And in this regard, to sustain all of these shenanigans in Kwara State, they had to recruit the jobless youth as well. They're everywhere. If you want to join politics in Nigeria and you have this so much money, the youth are everywhere, you know, the jobless ones. They are ready. They are willing. They will ask you. They will tell you, give us money. We'll do the job. Don't worry about us, sir. We are ready to die for you, sir. Just give us something. They are there. So the Saraki family used, they had their own fair share of that. You know what I mean now? Because they've never had responsible for anything. Nobody owed them responsible for running down a bank. In fact, it was two banks. I forgot the second name of the second bank they ran bankrupt. Nobody cared about their thousands of customers. What happened to them if they get their money back or if there's any compensation, whatever, whatever. I think nobody cared about that. It's Nigeria. They will survive. Like the MMM that keeps happening and happening, Ponzi schemes that keep happening and happening in Nigeria. Nigerians will survive. Nobody investigates who started it, who goes to jail for it. Nothing. So Saraki got away for 8 solid years. And throughout that 8 years, a new phase of public fund plundering, mismanagement, name it, underdevelopment that you can see today. And there are those that will come to you and say, Rome was not built in a day. But they could start their own mansion and build it within a month. And you will go there and you'll be like, wow, this place used to be bush. They cleared it and they built this beautiful mansion here in a month. There are those that want to have a burial ceremony or wedding ceremony for their children. And they will start putting up street lights on the same road, on the same street they want to have the wedding. This is the type of people. He ruled Kwara for 8 years and he got away with everything there. In fact, he managed to put his Stuji Ahmed Fattah in power to continue plundering the resources of Kwara State. It's a give and take thing. Then from this nowhere, the people of Kwara State have been one way or the other battered through the corrupt chain of succession, political succession of Saraki dynasty in Kwara State. People who have been victim of that generational, what do you call it? Succession of political power in a single family. The victims. Violence was unleashed on them on the April of this month, of this year. Of our people woke up like every other day, only to be sent to their early grave. 33 of them, including 8 policemen, were killed by these unscrupulous elements who were products of the Saraki political dynasty. Yes, people have been saying it. It's trending. The allegation of the police against Saraki is a political witch hunt. Look at us. Look at all the victims. You want to fight for Saraki? You know better. The police is lying. The police are lying, and then the police BRO is lying. They are cooking up this story to bring Saraki down. That is on the other side. What about those things now that they are now possibly presenting as evidence of the relationship between those arrested and the government of Kwara State? In a country where human beings are in charge of the government, not animals like we have in our country. This is a serious national security issue. If the police of a country can stand up and accuse those in authority of arming youth and criminals who are now confessing to have killed people they told to kill, including the Ofa robbery. We know these guys, an election is coming. Some people are now saying that Saraki should not be seen as an armed robber. Because why would he rob when he's already sitting on on the 100 billion naira National Assembly budget? He doesn't need to steal. How much money can these people really take in a bank robbery that Saraki cannot just sign on a check? This is how we are programmed. A crime took place, 33 Nigerians died. And the only thing our police could present to us as evidence is now being trashed by all of you who are going to end up being the victim, because we are those who always defend them and get them off the hook until they do it again. Until they do it again. Oh no, they can't buy guns for criminals, but yet we know politicians buy guns for criminals. Who are the politicians who buy guns for these people? How come that during election time, we always have this small good weapons into Nigeria being confiscated, and those that they never caught goes into the country and we don't know who ordered them in, and then we don't know how they get to the hands of the criminals? It's because we trash everything and just feel like we should defend them because they are victim of their own political machination. They joined this APC nonsense. They chose to, and they got power through it. Only for you to not be the ones to defend them. You know, that's the funniest thing. When you talk about those who never really meant anything good for us, Politicians buy guns for the jobless, lazy Nigerian youth to perpetuate just one thing, to destroy, be it property or life. And this is exactly the life we are living. Politicians buy weapons for political miscreants to cause havoc. And when once election is won and lost, they face their politics or whatever that comes out of the election. Nobody cares about the guns in the hands of these criminals. And when they eventually possibly run out of cash, political cash or, you know, campaign money given to them during the election when they were being given the guns, when they run out of cash, they have to come and disturb you, disturb me, disturb every one of us who never partook in their election money campaign. The campaign money. They will now use this gun like what happened in Ofa. People who woke up, victims of a government failure, the victims, murders, young people, police officers who, no matter the condition they go through in Nigeria, no matter how terrible their situation is in Nigeria, they have no right to go on strike. The police officers, as bad as they are, because now the whole thing is just like muddled up, like fokumoyo is what we call it in Yoruba. It's fokumoyo. When you mix oil with salt and every other, you just break everything together. It won't not anything, you know, it won't make any sense at the end of the day. That's exactly what is going on. These guys, because they wanted to feel protected and they understand the terrain so much, they understand the, you know, they are political miscreants. They have followed their political leaders to every nook and cranny of the state. They know Ofa, they know Oru, they know Kwara, they know Ilori. They know everywhere. They know where the police post stays or is located. They know where banks are. They know the distance. They know how many police officers works here, because there are people who have access to right information. They know who is the DPO in that area now. How does it work? What is he a friend? Oh, he's not a friend. How armed are these police posts? They know everything because they are closer to the people in authority. The people you give your power to every now and then, we never really value the power you give to them. They don't value it. That the power you are giving to them is to protect you from every unscrupulous elements like those they buy guns for. So this guy walked into Ofa, that beautiful money. Many people who died. I saw a woman in the video, in the CCTV video released of the robbery. A woman was walking into the bank with her daughter. A little baby, you know, a young child, a little, you know, girl. Then they started shooting. The woman ran. I don't know if she survived it. There is a marketer in Nigeria called Excel, a Yoruba movie marketer in Nigeria. His wife was in that bank that day, and she lost her life that day. She was killed by the bullet of these killers. She was killed. And that affects a lot of things to this day for that man, because I'm personally aware of that. So now, finally, the police released maybe I should just remind you guys how they arrested these criminals. They were not arrested by just being picked up on the street, set up for something, or possibly like they were like trying to set up Saraki and the rest of them. Let us go back to how they got arrested. They were arrested after the release of the CCTV and the pictures of the perpetrators of that criminal act. That was when they got arrested. Don't ever forget that. And among those arrested so far, none has claimed to be implicated. At least we have the picture of the four guys whose pictures were all over the internet. We have them now in custody with the police. These are the people we saw at the crime scene. They were those who killed people. So let Saraki stay on the side first, and let that your political sentiment as well stay on the side as well. Let us go back to the real thing. How did the police arrest these guys? They were arrested after the release of their pictures picked up by the CCTV at the bank in Ofa, where 33 people, 33 Nigerians were killed in cold blood. So these guys are now making confession. They are now telling us that though Saraki didn't send them to go and rob, but they were products of his political academy. In fact, they have direct pass into the state, into the government house in Kwara. These are things you should be looking at. These are things that should interest you. Not the political side and all this nonsense distraction they always bring up so that to take themselves out of the whole thing. This is a mess they created. They didn't send the guys to go and rob, but they bought guns, gave them cars, gave them money, and they gave them protection over the years. Only God knows when. Remember from when Saraki dynasty started in the 1999. If democracy is 19 years in Nigeria today, Saraki dynasty, like in this dispensation, started in 1999 with Dr. Olusola Saraki, who has been in control of all these political talks in Kwara State, like we had Adedibo in Ibadan in his life. So when we want to be partial, when we want to be sentimental, when we want to get drawn in this whole political confusion, it is always good for us to go back to where we are coming from. These guys were arrested. They were arrested after the release of their pictures to the world. They were not picked on the street randomly. They were not. People probably, some stop and search, those illegal arrests. These guys are not the ones in that category. You shouldn't feel pity for them just because Saraki's name is mentioned. You shouldn't feel pity for them just because Idris, that police IG, that we have come to see as the worst and the most embarrassing police IG Nigeria ever produced. Tafa Balogun was the one who was holding that award, that honor of the worst police officer ever, police inspector general ever produced, the most embarrassing by Nigeria. But come on, we now have Idris, the Mr. Transmission Transmitter, that is causing confusion, compulsion and the apprehensive in the system. Apprehension, transfusion, transmission, and all the nonsense. That is also aside. Let us put that aside. Let us now just look at the evidence. What is before us? Before you put all those sentiments into place. Buhari wants to destroy his enemy. Buhari wants to kill this and that. But the people you want to defend are not interested, whether you live or dead. As long as they hold office, forget it. In Ogun State, where I come from, we have a leader of the political thugs there who work directly with the governor. One day, the current Ogun State governor, Ibikunle Amosun, will no longer be in office. The thugs he's been using in the last 8 years, who has been controlling the motor parks, controlling the Okada garages, controlling the daily collection of tax and other from all these people. One day, the man that put them there will no longer be in power. And they will be at the mercy of what they can do then. Some of them will have nothing to do. You know, when you are used to free money, it's so difficult to create something productive. Like, it's very difficult. That is why sometimes when people are saying they want to be rich, they want money. Sometimes you have the money, or if you don't really have that wherewithal of reproductions, multiplying, creative to multiply. If you don't have it, you can have 1 billion naira today, like Buhari, who has 150 cows in 1999, 150 cows in 2003. 150 cows in 2007, 150 cows in 2011, 150 cows in 2015.
These are people that if you give them 1 billion, they will go and dig ground and put it under the ground and say, I'm a billionaire and I know where my money is. They don't think to multiply, and all they care about is how much of that money I have in paper. So let us put all the sentiment aside now and let us look at the evidence before us before you start defending who you shouldn't defend. One day, like I said, Amazon will leave power. One day, Tinubu will no longer have control over the power in Lagos. All the thugs he's been using in the last 19 years in Lagos, in the case of Ogun State, all the thugs Amazon has been using in the last 8 years, the day they have no access to that free money, free violence, and free killings, they will want to do something to survive. And because what they know is violence, then you and I are going to be the victim. That is why you shouldn't be backing, what do you call it? That's why you shouldn't be backing Saraki, backing Buhari, backing police, backing this and that. We should just look at the evidence before us. People died. It is time for Nigerians to get the real sense and the truth behind all this nonsense and stop looking at the peripheral of the whole thing, like the old flashy stuff of it. It's deeper than that. And that is where you should leave the sentiment of being PDP and APC, or maybe Buhari wants to bring Saraki down. It could be in our own interest. It could be in the interest of the Kwara people that Buhari destroys Saraki. And in this regard, it will be in the interest of Nigerians. If Saraki can help us destroy Buhari, and all of us won't have to fight, we won't have to do anything, they will just destroy themselves. But the moment you start backing them and you start feeling like, oh, it's not good for Saraki to fight Buhari, it's not good for Buhari to fight Saraki and the rest of that, you're actually giving them a lifeline. That's exactly what you're doing. And that's exactly what will take me to the Yorubas supporting Buhari because of religion. I have many of you on my page, and it's so unfortunate that you have allowed yourself to be caught up in this confusion, a state of confusion whereby even your religion is not helping you. Your religion, your faith is not helping you. And if you are supporting Buhari because of your religion, you need help. And I'm going to tell you why you need help this evening. I'm a young man that possibly, I'm a young man misunderstood by so many people. And with time, I believe that many will still come back to say, wow, I think I get what you are trying to say, what you are trying to do now. And that is why, for those who are consistently defending their religion, affiliation with Buhari and Oshibajo, it is a total state of stupidity. Because if your faith is the reason why you believe so much in these people and you want to support them and make sure they succeed, here is the problem. Your faith may be that strong, but they don't have the same faith as you. Everything they represent contradicts everything you represent. The only confusion here is that you've not told yourself the truth. A genuine Muslim will fight to defend the life of the vulnerable. It's in the Quran. I read that first tira, they call it Torah or tira, the one where you start learning Alif, Bata, Sa, Jim, Ha, you know. Then you go back to the Quran. I'm just like a rebel. I've always been a rebel. And that is why I've never bowed for anything. I go into things to understand, not to be controlled by that thing. And same thing with religion. Very beautiful. Christianity is beautiful. Islam is beautiful. You know, their teachings are solid for those who can take their time to really read the two books. And for those who strongly believe in them. But this belief, this faith, has sort of been misdirected politically, in my own opinion. And I have to tell you, Buhari is a Nigerian by the virtue of the office he's holding. Osinbajo is a Nigerian by the virtue of the office he's holding. They both came to power for different reasons. Some supported them because of their tribe. Some supported them because of their religion. Some supported them because of their political affiliation. Some supported them because of their integrity, the packaged integrity. But there is no Christian, there is no Muslim that has power, enormous power of state as the president of a country. Now, let us not even say he's a president of the country. Now, I say he's a Christian or he's a Muslim who is a leader of a country. And every day, he knows the power he controls. He knows the enormous power in their possession as the president and vice president of the country. And they could have just saved the whole day without us having to identify who is a Christian or who is a Muslim killed or, illegally detained by the police. But these guys have not really done anything genuinely to concretize, as in to confirm that faith you have in them. Everything your Bible teaches you about leaders, do these people have them? All these things your Quran taught you about leadership, do these people have them? Do they portray them, or they just talk about them? And because they have managed to manipulate you over time, they've manipulated your parents over time. And they have managed to manipulate generations before you over time to believe that you can't challenge the people in authority because God put them there. God doesn't put anybody anywhere. I'll keep saying this. It is not because I don't believe in God. It is in fact because I know I believe in God and I know what God can genuinely do. Not what you think he should do, because what your religious leader says God told him that he can do. It's in the Bible there that God lives in us. We live in God because he created us in his own image. And that alone tells me that inside me lives God. And if I can identify what is wrong, differentiate what is wrong from what is right. So God doesn't put people in power. People seek power. They work for it. They scheme for it. They kill for it. It's not God. When people tell you the story around power and they make it look like it's ordained, like they use religion to tell you something is ordained, something is this, God said it's this, then you should start asking yourself, does God hate Nigerians? Should you not ask yourself, like, could God, possibly even God hate us? Because if he loves us, if he genuinely loves us and is choosing leaders for us, how come that only crazy criminals are imagined as our leaders? Have you asked yourself? God is a just God. He said, everything I have created perfectly.
Everything I created is good. Ask yourself. Ask your brothers. Ask your sisters. Ask your pastors. Ask your imams that tells you that God chooses leaders. Sometimes when they don't know what to tell you, they say God wants to punish us. That's why he gives us bad leaders. God has been punishing us since 1960. 58 years. What can we do? We'll be Israelites in Egypt. What did we do? We are now exporting religion. We are exporting miracles. But we couldn't call. We even have what we call national prayer. How come God so much? These people will make us talk blasphemy against God. And that is where you have to come back to your senses. They are mad people. Both in churches and in mosques. These are crazy animals. Using the book that I believe are written in clear, the interpretation you give the book is yours. God is not stupid. Does Buhari represent Muslim or Islam? Does Buhari represent what genuine Islam teaches? Genuine Islam says a leader cannot eat when his followers are yet to eat. But every weekend, you see them, they are breaking fast. They set the table. They hide the alcoholic stuff. They put that one in another room for those who want to drink. When they want to supply our beautiful young women to warm the bed of these criminals, they put them off the camera. You will never see them on camera. They come to our churches. We give them the special seat at the front of the auditorium. We give them special places everywhere they go because they call them honorables, distinguished, excellencies. And they are supporting the progress of the religion. It is disheartening. It is heartbreaking. It is embarrassing that everything that we touch in Nigeria, we rebrand it to whatever suits us. And when we start getting punished by that decision, we always have another excuse to cover our failure. Oshibajo is a pastor. He's so scared to talk about the killings of the Christians. I'm taking it to this route because we have so many people who personally comes on my ghost diary to accuse me of deliberately campaigning against Church of Christ in Nigeria. You are mad people. Someone like me, I've seen it. I may be young. Someone like me, I've seen it all. And to allow myself to be deceived by the same thing, I know how it operates, will be my own making. That will be my own making. I won't have any excuse for that. There's this guy also on social media who is also using the same religion and all that to deceive people, collect money from them, pray for them through this medium. I'm using my laptop here now so I could pass anointing to people who believe in anointings. I could possibly start giving you visions now. And in this audience of 265 people watching, I will get like 5 or 6 people that whatever I'm going to say is going to be, it's going to relate to what they are going through right now. And for those who live in Nigeria, those who are making this religion of a thing look like there's this one thunder, there's this one angel There's this one God coming somewhere to destroy anyone that talks about the criminals who are using the church to rip you off, and they are working with the criminals in government. That is why you will never see anybody in government to regulate the activities of the church, the activities of the mosque. They don't go deeper. When they try to do it on the surface, because they are trying to destroy what they built. Because through church, through mosque, they have been able to control the mind of the people in the country. So even when you are angry, you want to go and fight, your imam will tell you, don't fight. If you fight them, you are fighting God. Which God? Nigerian God is a different God entirely. It is the God that answers our prayer when we say something bad should happen to people. But when we say good things should happen to our country, that God doesn't listen. Have you asked yourself why? It's a common sense thing. Some will say, the war is not carnal, or maybe it's carnal, whatever they call it. But my guy, my people, let's bring ourselves back here. How come all these things are not working for us? So if you are still those who believe that your religion, if anybody criticizes Buhari, they are trying to bring down your religion. You are a madman. I've never heard the way I address those who support Buhari and Oshibajo, especially the Yorubas who are supporting them. The suffering and smiling goat heads all around the place. They are the politically correct morons on social media. I've told people never to respect them. Don't respect them. Some of them are older. Some of them are educated, but they are morons. When you see someone who is educated, trying to defend Buhari, even Buhari came out and said, it is very difficult to defend me. Yeah, you are Bill Okaba. You said I'm a Christian and I support Buhari. You are not supporting Buhari because you are a Christian. You are supporting Oshibajo because Oshibajo is the pastor. You are a moron. So take it to the bank. You are a moron. Is that you are not living in Nigeria? If you are living in Nigeria and you are following them because you are a Christian, now I am saying this to you. You are one of those humble slaves that we are praying for. There are many people on the mountain now praying for all you morons, all you deluded morons who are putting us back in this mess. The country your Christian brother is supervising, Oshibajo, the fake pastor, is the country where if them burn you well, go and carry your Bible now and go to Maiduguri and start preaching. Do you understand now? Carry your Bible now and go to Borno and start preaching Jesus. And then come back here and tell me I'm a Christian and I support Buhari. Many of you are supporting Buhari because of Oshibajo and because of the Baba Gio Adeboye, the number 1419 kingpin in Nigeria today. I say it with all mouth. All of them will collapse until they stop meddling in our politics, until they stop using the same coercion mechanism, the threat of the curses in the Bible to threaten our people to submission, the coercion mechanism, until they stop meddling. Do you get that now? Until they stop giving us all this useless every year prophecy, they will never get any respect from us. And there is no angel that will do anything. Nothing. Because the only thing your angel does, the only thing your God always do for you, is to say, if anybody say anything about your GO, something must happen to him, and you'll be monitoring, something must happen to him, so that you can prove that your God is powerful. But that same God, that your God, cannot fix Nigeria. Nigeria is too complicated for that your God. It's time to ask yourself this. I know the brainwashing and all that has been here for far, far too long. Even before my own father and mother were born, they've been brainwashing all of us. So I know about it. It's not your fault. The brainwashing and all that is superb. That is why a pastor can kick someone who is pregnant and say he's trying to heal her so that he could, I mean, she could have the baby, kicking the stomach of someone who is pregnant. It's because of the brainwash all of you. Your God cannot fix Nigeria. I'm not afraid to talk about that your God, that your useless God, that many of you are clinging on to. The God you have been praying to that couldn't, for once, fix Nigeria for us. Religion, 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 religion. They go to the church every Sunday. They look for the most scary part in the Bible, the most scary chapters, and the most scary, the most, you know, scary part of the Bible. They preach on them.
The truth of the matter is this. We will eventually treat it. We know your type. Your God now, your prayer right now is that. Is either I stop saying this or your God will come and do something. Is that not your prayer? Is that not your God? Ask yourself, what else can your God do? The God that protects thieves in your church. The God that protects criminals becoming your deacon in your church. Killers, politicians. The God of Cecilia Ibru. The God that made Cecilia Ibru a pastor. The God that made Erastus Akinbola a pastor. Anointing, anointed. Where's your God?
Politicians are working with these people, and every year, in order to manage us properly, to control our mind, prophecy will start coming up soon. They will start telling us who is going to win the next election. They will start telling us how many people will die. They will start telling us this blah, 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 blah. But they couldn't tell that God that they will send to Mayegu now, because some of them will be like telling God to go and, they will say, my their angel should go and teach this boy talking. Go and teach him a lesson. You don't have any God that couldn't even like make our country work. Did you get that now? The intimidation, the harassment, the threat of what your angel can do when we know many of your pastors. I'm from Ijebu. I am an Ijebu man to the core. Do you get that now? Many of your pastors come to my town to go and have their own ifa, to come and, you know, make sacrifice to Ogun. He's my town. That is why I studied the Quran. I didn't finish it. That's why I won't say much on these two books, Bible and Quran. But I studied both to understand the fact that they both represent love. And they both represent, and they both preaches protecting the weak and the vulnerable, the women and the children. You don't rape them because they are vulnerable. You don't wage war. When you are fighting your war, you protect the women and the children. But in Nigeria, you know, there's nothing like that. They kill you at will, and the moment you want to react, they take you back to church. They tell you that you must not react. You get that now? You must not react, or else. In the Bible, they said those who criticize Elijah. Lion came out from somewhere and he just tore them into pieces. They said those who criticized so. Fire from heaven just fell and it consumed all of them in their millions with their horses. Alaye live story. Nigeria no be Egypt. I mean, Nigeria no be Jordan. Nigeria no be Jerusalem. You get that now? So if any lion won't come out, let them come out and tear anybody. We go put them for their Facebook Live. At least that's to solidify your fear. That is the only thing your God does. Destroy anyone that tries to question and try to tell you to ask the right question. Because that is exactly what is going on. You know, they come to my town, they take all these things. We have them in plenty. Abijabu boy, like I said, we have them in plenty. That's why I don't fear anybody. You see, there is nothing to fear when you know that those who are going to come and try all this nonsense will still eventually possibly have to use the same instrument they are always denying out there.
And that is our own Ibile. That is why I am like 3-in-1. You cannot deceive me with your Holy Spirit that can fix Nigeria in 58 years. The Holy Spirit and your fake God and the rest of all those nonsense you put up out there to intimidate, to scare people, to coerce them into submission, to give whatever they have and promise them what possibly you yourself knows that you don't even know if you're going to get there. Heaven. They don't spend money in heaven. They don't fly jets in heaven. They don't drive limousine in heaven and the rest of that. But I don't even have problem with all of that. They are all job men. Let them take the money. But me, they leave our politics. And they must stop meddling. Do you get that now? Let them keep all their sheep in the church. Continue taking their money. Passing the message of heaven to them. Talk, but they must remove politics. They must remove prophecy every year, prophecy. That fake prophecy they always make. They are going to start coming out and start giving us that fake prophecies again. So person will win. No, that person will not win. In the same country, they are calling the same God, calling the same Jesus, calling the same Holy Spirit. But they will give us like 500 prophecies of different ones that will not look alike. And someone will tell me that the Holy Spirit is so powerful that it can only destroy people who ask questions. But the Holy Spirit will never touch the people who are killing Christians, who are killing Muslims, and the rest of that. So please, keep your Holy Spirit. I know they're that category. The Holy Spirit, the Spirit will be inside me. Eh? Let your Holy Spirit come and try it. Many of you have tried. Many of you have tried. Let them leave our politics. We will not, you see, if they leave our politics, we will not tamper with church. We will not care. But stop using the word of God to protect criminals and start telling people that they must not fight them. Because God said they must not fight their leaders. Because God appointed leaders. God did not appoint any leader in Nigeria or anywhere else. People aspire to lead. Go and check it anywhere. They say, but you can aspire to lead, but it's only God that will make you lead. Now lie. If 10 people, they fight for one thing, now one person go get time. So leave that story about your God and this and that. We have way God is working for us. Many of us know God, and we know how we talk to God. But the level many of you Nigerians are sort of taking this issue of your God and the rest of that is why the politicians will always use that avenue to pass their message to you through their colleagues, the pastors, the imam, the chief imam, the this, the that, those who can use their position to influence multitude of people, you know, to influence them and tell them don't do this. So in the north, you will see the preachers on a Friday where everyone just, you know, possibly goes in to pray to God. They just pray to God, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, Ayah al-Salat, Ayah al-Falak, you know, all that. Before they change them for me. They just prayed in mosque, Jumat prayer. And the imam will tell them that they should go out now and kill infidels. Who are the infidels? Christians, Nigerians. From where they just pray to God, they pray for Astagafrula, Astagafrula, Astagafrula. The 11 Astagafrula that you have to count when you finish praying. Astagafrula, Astagafrula, Astagafrula. God forgive me, God forgive me, God forgive me of my sins. Right there, someone is telling them to go and kill, and they will move to the streets like that. And they will start burning buildings. They will start burning shops. They will start killing people. Police will be drafted. Army will be drafted in. And they will start trying to calm the whole thing down. Before you know it, 40 people die. I mean, 40 people dead. They will move from church. I mean, from mosque. Are you telling me that's what the religion teaches them? No. Politicians are those behind all of this. When you see your religious leader, or your religion leader, I mean, religion leader, meddling in politics, just know that is that politicians as friends. Do you get that? Is that friends who are politicians? Then he will come forward and he will say, in the name of Allah. And everybody will say, hey, Allah, I want to talk. What did Allah say?
They say, Allah says you must kill all infidels. They are neighbors. People who they live together for God knows how long. And they'll say, Allah said they must kill infidels. They'll give their name, infidels. And they'll go out there and they'll start killing people in the name of Allah. Right there from the mosque. And when you talk about it, a Muslim lunatic on social media wants to think you are attacking his religion. Oh, you are attacking my religion. You don't know what you're talking about. You are attacking my religion. You are mad. You are mad. Your religion is attacking our life. Some of us don't believe in religion. And because you do, it's causing problem now. It's causing problem. And we have two people who became prominent people in this 21st century because they were Christian and Muslim. I will never forget. I will never forget that. You can't change narrative. I mean, you can't change that narrative. All of a sudden, oh, it's not about religion. Don't bring religion into this. Are you mad? Forget it. It's about religion. That's how Buhari and Oshibajo emerged. When Buhari was running, the campaign out there was he was going to Islamize Nigeria. And APC was like, how could they really, you know, patch that up to make sure it doesn't affect, I mean, it didn't affect the election then. They brought a pastor, including a poster that says a general will lead and a pastor will support. Which means if a general is tough, a pastor can always come in and calm the situation. That is exactly what they employed Oshibajo for. So where is that your religious or religion connection with Buhari and Oshibajo? If an Hausa man, even a Muslim who is an Hausa man, carries praying mat and is a ketu, that ketu, the, you know, for ablution, alwala, and it just possibly maybe about four or five of them, if they shoot from the blues, you just see them lay their mat in the open in Anambra, which is a Christian dominated area, Igbo region. You cannot guarantee their safety. That's the reality of their religion in this regard. And when you trace it, these were people we used to live together before. We used to see ourselves as brothers and sisters. We gave ourselves names. Aboki is my friend. Even though many people, when you say Aboki, they think you are abusing an Hausa man. When we were growing up, Aboki means my friend. But it was when we as kids, we started calling Aboki because they didn't understand Yoruba. So we could possibly like start talking Yoruba now. And an Hausa man who is in our midst won't understand. So we call them, we use this Aboki. So we use like a slang. But Aboki genuinely means my friend. Aboki. That's how we grew up. We never saw Aboki as enemy then. No? We never saw them as enemy. We grew up with them. But the moment politics takes shape and politics started entering churches, politics started entering mosques, politics started entering everything, politicians started using every available platform to divide us, we began suspecting ourselves. So everybody now walks about with something to defend himself. And Aboki will walk about with his dagger. Because they've told him in his mosque, when he was coming down to the south, that he's going to the land of the infidels. They could kill him. Or they could convert him to another religion. So he's walking about with his dagger in his pocket. A Yoruba man that they have told that Aboki always carry dagger. Because they have also brainwashed him and he's bought it in this current day Nigeria. He will go back home, go and get Okigbe, Ayeta, Aluwo, Anosare. For those who are Yorubas, they know what I'm talking about. It's called self-defense. Who are you defending yourself against? Another man they have also brainwashed to be careful of you. Who are those behind all of this? Religious leaders and political leaders. It is to their advantage. So when your religion says you love Buhari because you are a Christian, and I tell you that you are a mad person to believe that, if you genuinely believe that, it's because you have madness in you. It's absolute madness. Don't make Nigeria look like we never grew up in that country. We grew up there. Aboki are those who are digging our wells. Konga, they are those who are working on our farms. Today, Aboki is no longer working on our farms anymore. He's bringing his cow to come and destroy our farms. It never used to be like that. But politicians came in and they planted this seed of discord. Sorry, I'm trying to read some comment there, but it's like it's going up too fast, so I couldn't really read it. But I think you guys are enjoying this anyway, which is very good. People don't like this. And I don't like when I'm trying to bring something up for us to sit down and think. It is not to judge or to make anyone feel bad. And if you feel bad in this, it means you have to look into what I'm talking about. I feel bad when people bring their religion nonsense, their Holy Spirit, their God that is always good at destroying people. It never makes anything good. Their God never fixes anything. Even their God never fixed their lives. It's always about destroying people. Destroying someone who is talking about your pastor. Destroying someone who is talking about your leader. Destroying someone who is talking about your tribe. To the point that in Nigeria, we have now developed or we have designed this special thunder that people will be asking you, how do you want your thunder? Cold or warm? Stay in one place so that this thunder can locate you. Because that is the only thing we can offer. Like, something must happen to him. Let something happen to him to teach him a lesson. He's talking blah, 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 blah. All your pastors combined. They told us something will happen to this guy. What's that guy's name? The guy that was tackling them on this tight of a thing. That's the only thing your God seems to be good at. But God is not good at fixing things. And if you have not been thinking about that before, I'm asking you to start thinking about it now. Ask your pastors. Ask them. Do you understand now? So we must leave sentiment out of this. Let the church be separated from politics. I know it's very difficult. Because it's like, rub my back, I rub your back. The politician who is a thief, he will tax a church if he knows how much they are making. Politicians just want money. They don't care about anything. Churches just want money. And they care about their money. Figure that out. And they have to protect it. So in order to be protected, they must be real players in the game. That is why your pastors are now politicians. They know politics more than many of you in your church. Now your pastor that you expect to be so deep in religion, in Christian, whatever, your imam, that you expect to be so deep in Quranic researches. Now your pastor that should be so good in spiritual researches. He's so deep in politics, deeper than you. Your pastor is pursuing contracts in different government houses through his own proxies. And he will tell you, we have to pray for our leaders. Father, Lord Jesus, they are so good. They are so good. I could add that. Like, assuming many of you didn't know me as Mayegu, I could just come up and become a pastor. You will still love it because all these things are, you can practice them and you become perfect. Do you get that? He said, ladies and gentlemen, it's so crazy now, you know, they meddled in our politics, and politics is fucking up with our lives as a people, and pastors are protecting them. So if you are a Muslim and you are supporting Buhari because of your religion, and you see that whoever talks about Buhari is trying to attack your religion, you are a madman. And if you are a woman, you are a mad woman. You will not know, because even mad people will never know. They never believe that they are mad. Ask mad people. They will tell you, Do you think I'm mad? Do you think I'm really mad? Mad people, they will tell you, they will ask you. Because it's only a mad person. Eh? That couldn't afford, that someone that can't afford to feed his family, can't afford to pay his own school, I mean, to pay his children's school fees. You can't afford to pay rent. You are still looking for a job. Even though you say you are living on grace. Many of you, when you meet them today, say, how is everything? They say, ah, Baba, we are living on grace. So, which grace? You say, Baba, man, everything is tough, but Baba, with the grace of God, we are still here. We are surviving. God is good. God is wonderful. It's been. You are surviving for another day. That is not the life you deserve. If you are genuinely serving that God. God is a very good and wonderful, thing. I won't say thing because they will start telling me that you are calling God thing. Well, God is a wonderful thing. Let's take it like that. And then let me know if that your God will not accept to be called something. God is beautiful to all of us. He's given us the chance. He said, go into the world and multiply. Do you get that? Go and become whatever you want to become. But keep my commandments. What are the commandments of God? Love your neighbor as yourself. He didn't say love your neighbor more than yourself. He didn't say love yourself more than your neighbor. He said as long as you love yourself, love your neighbor equally. Politicians today are preaching to us to hate our neighbors. Even pastors today are preaching to us to hate our neighbors because of politics. Where is that your Holy Spirit and that your brand of Allah? We know the real Allah. The Allah they are talking about is the same God. Allah, God, Eledumare, in different languages. But they have brainwashed us so badly that people feel offended when they hear Allah. Say Allah is a dead God. It's only Jesus that is a living God. When you meet a Muslim, he says, there's no Jesus. Jesus is just a prophet. Muhammad is this and that. What is wrong with you guys? When we want to do that, let us go to church and mosque. Not when we are talking about the fake pastor Oshibajo or talking about that jihadist, know nothing Buhari. It is not hate speech. Some will say it's hate speech. It is not hate speech. There is no one who hates us more than the one that watches us killed and do nothing. That's the person that hates us more. Let me tell you something. If someone sees that they are about to kill you and he has the power to stop it and he just looks the other way, then come to your barrier and start talking about how wonderful it could have been to have you here, that you didn't die. That's the most wicked person. No? That is the most wicked person. And in 2019, we will trash religion, influence in politics in Nigeria. So start telling your pastors, those your pastors you love so much, those your men of God with anointing on their head, only God knows what type of anointing. They told us in the Bible that so many prophets, they commanded mountain to move, they commanded there something. In Ijebu, where I come from, I get people that will tell a whole tree to fall, and it will fall. If you don't know, make I tell you. They are not pastors. Oh. In Ijebu, where I come from, I have people that will tell a whole tree, the leaves on a tree, to wither. And right there in your present eye, right there in your present, the whole tree will wither, the whole leaves will wither, and it will go dead. They are not Christians. They don't have Holy Spirit. And that is what those your fake miracle workers called, they call it something. There's this particular name they give to our African, what do you call African solutions? Something evil, evil. They always attach evil to something they don't want you to touch, because the moment you touch it, you know what I mean now, you get to start challenging your pastors. You say, "Pastor, shut up. Listen. You better behave. We will not treat ourselves. We will not treat the fuck up of ourselves. You better behave." And your pastors that know the levels, they use their brain. It's only you who allow them to manipulate you to the end. Every one of you who've managed to have testimonies of what God has done for you, go and check it. They didn't come from anybody but yourselves, because the capacity is already there. Tell your pastors to stay away from our politics in 2019. They should keep all their fake, fake prophecies. They always have this release every time that we are going to have election. They always give us all these mad releases and all that. And in fact, when you hear them say Buhari is going to win, if any pastor tells you that Buhari is going to win, it's because the Buhari people have seen him. If anybody tells you that the Buhari is not going to win, it's because the people of Buhari have not seen him. Do you get that now? There's so many things that goes on out there. So they will not use that on us. And all of you, Facebook prayer warriors, Facebook Holy Spirit tech carriers, we are here. Do you get that now? We are here. As long as you tell your pastors to stay away from our politics, to stop telling us to calm down, to stop telling us to cool down for these criminals, to stop telling us that God appointed all these criminals, if they stay away, we will respect the church. They have bastardized the church enough. We are not stupid. There is no war against the church in Nigeria. The war is in the church in Nigeria. There's no war coming from anywhere. Because if there is war coming from anywhere, the number two man in Nigeria is a Christian. He is capable. He should be capable to save you. The real war is within your church, where you refuse to tell yourselves the truth. And you are living an illusion that you must not challenge them, because you don't want to have the same treatment given to Elisha or Elijah. You don't want lion to tear you. You don't want to be wretched in life, because prophet must not curse you. They are mad. Tell you all your prophet to do live video and start cursing us. The one they cursed us with, they are cursed People's Congress, APC. The curse is all over the country now. It's on everybody. Do you get that now? Tell your pastors to stay away from our politics. They should stay away. They should not advise us what to do with those criminals. And when you go to church next Sunday, tell your pastor, "Pastor, stay away from politics. Pastor, please stay away from politics." They can't do anything to us, nothing. That's why you see your pastor arresting people. Because he has no anointing anywhere. All na job. All of us, they carry anointing. Go lay down for your room now and tell God, say, "God, I won't fight these political criminals. God, make sure my pastor no even get on my way. If he stand on my way, I go treat him won't fuck up too." Go inside your room and see if anointing will go follow you. Anointing, solid one. Undiluted. Your pastors that is wearing all this olugbo, all those things, all their churches. We are seeing everything everywhere now. It's only when they are caught that they become evil pastor. But when they are not caught, they are the only pastor. They can bring mountain. Tell your pastor, "Man, come try out. We dey here. A live video. We dey here." Some of you are pastors, sir. You dey watch me. The anointing you should be carrying about now is the anointing that will give us good leaders. And you know you don't have the capacity, because you are all terrible, some of you. Terrible people. Much, much like Atlas than those in government. But because you are protected, you know, because they all attend your church. Minister attend your church and they get special place there. Governors come to your church, they get a better place there. And the same governor will go back to his government house.
where they gave him all everything that he's using to control the whole state and the rest of that in his head. He'll go back there on his own. Sharp guy. He'll come and destroy my own. He'll go and spoil my own with that, your fake this thing. You're teaching your anointing at the comfort for your church. Now the crowd, they are coming for, not your anointing. Stop deceiving yourself. They are coming for the crowd. Politicians love crowd. And when they see crowd anywhere, they are interested. You're not coming for any anointing. You are just all jobbing yourself. You understand now? Anointing that some of us carry is more powerful than whatever those Jankara, Olubo from Inesekiti, Oyekiti, all those mountains where you will see why garment churches, pastors, prophets. Under them, they have own day everything. They say, Coca-Cola, bomb operate. We be Yoruba. This time, where all of you just came with this, your Pentecostal, this thing. Started bamboozing all of us with English. Bamboozing all of us with all these different stories. Rearranging the Bible. Start printing different books that keeps, fingering the brain of our people. When you bring all this, your Pentecostal, this thing. The reason why I'm saying this. Number one thing, your Pentecostal churches and the rest of them, all of them combined, all their anointing, all of their whatever, all of your daddy geos, all of your everything, cut this video and send it to them. They can't do anything to me. We'll go meet, we'll go dragon. You get that? We'll go dragon. Let them stay away from our politics. Simple as ABC. Start telling them, pastor, stay away from politics. And if you want to do politics, no who know where you take. No, they use Bible, they arrange us, they use Bible, they cajole us. They tell us say one thing go happen if we talk about prophets. Either they mad, each prophet, nothing there. The politic prophet, if your prophet wants to do anything that is going to affect me, I will tell you the content of what he's going to use to try and fight me. I will tell him if your pastor come with his Bible. You get me now? And started shouting, all those nonsense. I will tell him, Alaye, calm down. Take off your garment and let's see you, Abija. Let's see everything we're doing under. All this, your Bible, all this nonsense. You know, if you work, we know, say, no, be that thing go work. Drop the Bible and take off your shirt and let's see what's in there under. So I go take off my own shirt too. We'll go see what's in there under. Then we'll rub mind. At the end of the day, we'll just shake hands and say, oh boy, you're my personal. Just won't spoil business. No joke, but they speak Oyinbo here. You understand that? If I'm allowed, I'll speak Ijebu. I'll take you home, and I will take you home when I get to Nigeria very soon. I'll show you my hood. We know the joke with Adele. So your Holy Spirit, your Holy Bible, your Holy this, your Muhammad, your Tira, your everything. When we were growing up in Yoruba land, when I was growing up in Ijebu, all these things were never threats. They were just thoughts there to guide and make you become a responsible person. If this is what the religion says, and you have to be, all these things were there. They were never meant to be things we use in judging ourselves or trying to condemn and kill ourselves until politicians came. And that is why you must tell your church now. Tell your pastor. I know they won't hear because this little platform may not be enough for them to hear. You cannot support Buhari with all that is going on in Nigeria right now and say you are a Christian or you are a Muslim. Because even in your Bible, in your Quran, it's never there to kill people, harmless people. It's never there. Said if anybody threatened you, that's what the jihad says in the Quran. When people say Quran teaches war. During the time of Muhammad, it was wartime in the old world. Empires are being conquered, taken, and retaken back then. So you must be a warrior. And you need a place to put your people. So it means you have to keep conquering land. And you have to keep building army to sustain that and to protect whatever you've managed to get. That was what the world was then. No? You get that now? It was about war. You have to fight war to survive. And the jihad they brought into the book. Do you understand now? They call it jihad in the Bible. They call it, war on the wicked. They call it a jihad in the Quran. They call it war on the wicked in the Bible. In the Bible, they say you must never allow the witch to live. It means you must kill the witch. It's in the Bible that you must kill the witch. In Quran, they say you must stone an adulterous woman. In the Bible, they said you have to stone. In the Old Testament, you have to stone an adulterous woman as well. If you remember the woman that they said, the adulterous woman that ran to Jesus. And Jesus was like, he who has never sinned, she cast the first stone. That was the time. So if someone is now coming to come and threaten me with what was happening at that time, and I'm just going to keep quiet, when some people are using that same religion to put that nonsense in the head of some stupid people, telling them that some people are infidels, some people are unbelievers, some people are uncircumcised, segregating ourselves. Now, when we used to ignore this nonsense and never felt like we should be like controlled by them, we knew they were there, but we never felt like, you know. But today when you come to Yoruba land, you now start seeing some Boko Haram Yorubas. Because most of your Buhari supporters are just Boko Haram mentality, you know. There are people who enjoy seeing people cry, because it makes them feel powerful. Do you get that now? So if you're supporting Buhari and you're a Muslim and you think you are all right, you're just like our own Boko Haram. It's a matter of time before all of you will start buying guns and start killing us and say we are unbelievers. It's a matter of time. Because all these teachings goes on every day, until something happens. Then we start saying, when did it get to this? Okay, in Yoruba land, never. It has never happened in the story. It's going to happen when you keep following the likes of Buhari. Their teachings is that of Boko Haram. If you don't believe in us, something evil must happen to you. You must be destroyed. So we start saying Yorubas now because they support Buhari, they don't have feelings anymore. Like when you say something, they say, and so, now today people, they die. Yoruba. We maybe say we'll go see dead body, we'll go see, yay, oh my God, you know. Now people don't feel like that anymore because they support Buhari. Because when you raise it, they believe that you are targeting their Buhari. And when you target Buhari, you are targeting their religion. Because God chose Buhari for them. Imagine that mentality in our country. Just imagine that. Yoruba, because they love Buhari. When you say, the food, what do you call it? There is food are too expensive in Nigeria. We couldn't afford, you know, blah, 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 blah. A Buharist, or the Buhari didirins, like I used to call them. The Buhari dins, the Buhari didirins, the Buhari dinotus. Their uncles and their aunties living abroad, called the Mumu lecturers, the Bele lecturers, and the rest of them. They don't have feelings anymore. Have you noticed? Because I need to ask some of you. Have you noticed that those who support Buhari, they don't have feelings anymore? Or they tend not to have feelings? Or they pretend not to have feelings anymore? The only time they feel like, this is sad, is when Buhari is in London receiving treatment. Have you noticed? This is never used to be us. A little blood coming from a wrong part of the body to an average Yoruba man is a complete heartbreaker. We'll start shaking. We'll see dead bodies. You see our reaction. You say, now you die. Why you can't react like this? Bros, how come? They say, who die? They say, that woman, the next house, she died on Okada. Then you just see a Yoruba woman. She will just throw herself on the ground. Yeah! They say, do you know her? No, I don't know her. I just feel sorry for her children. They say, how come you now throw yourself up like that? That's who we used to be. Have you forgot that? That's what we used to be like. Like, we'll cry. They say we'll cry more than the bereaved.
But these days, we don't seem to have that feelings anymore. Have you noticed? If you haven't, please do. That is the effect of what religion has done to us. Buhari used religion, used all these Islamic preachers in the north to preach division, AIDS, destruction. How many of you remember the seven Youth Corps members killed in the north in 2011 election? They went there to serve. But because Buhari believed that, and you know, the NYSC drafted their corps members into INEC, ADIOC recruitment every election time. So Buhari, probably because they caught during the 2007 election, the worst election conducted by Nigeria or ever conducted in Nigeria so far. You remember 2007 election? Who was that INEC chairman then? After Ebel Gubadia, who was that guy that conducted the 2007 election? The worst ever. Even Yaradua, the beneficiary of the election, came out and said it was the worst election. We have to do something. So because Buhari lost that election, and the general belief among Buhari supporters in the north, including some Muslim, some Islamic clerics, who they have used slush money to build mosques for. They are their own sheikh in different mosques in all parts of the north. Do you get that now? They started preaching that the NYSC corps members were used by PDP to rig Buhari out. So in 2011, when Buhari lost, they targeted NYSC corps members that were posted to the north at the time. I think it happened in Bauchi. Seven of them were beaten. They were dragged out of their residence where they were staying. They were dragged out. It was a random act. Like, okay, the corps members were rigging for PDP. So we must deal with them today. You must kill every corps member you see. So this misguided, young and old religious bigots, they went to town looking for every corps member they could see and kill. It wasn't to arrest or beat. It was to kill. They caught many of them. Some fought their way and escaped. They killed seven in retaliation for losing 2011 election because of religion. So they use all these, what do you call them? All these worship centers, mosques, to recruit. Recruitment cells all over the north. Just like we have, it's just that those in the south who are pursuing Christianity, those in church, they are more interested in prosperity. Not Aljanna with 72 virgins. Prosperity, they want to have it here. You can't fly plane in heaven. So they use all these people to manipulate us, like I said. And you cannot come out and say, because I'm a Christian, that's why I'm supporting. We know why you are supporting them. So you don't worry. We know. It's because of that fake pastor, Oshibajo. He cannot help you. He will never help you. Because you see that religion you are holding with all your might, all your life, everything. They don't. The only reason why they are associating with you, the only reason why they are identifying with you is simply because of your number. Simple as ABC. It's because of your number.
Who is this Sayan Sahar speaking all this, you know? Okay, I'll take him out. You see, we'll get back to that. All this Asian troll, they call them BOT or is it bot? They're everywhere, invading every platform. Just be careful of them. If they send you a link that watch free movie here, if you click on my brother, your own, my sister, they send you a link and say follow this page for this and that. All those names, all those Asian names. I'm using the laptop, so I couldn't get rid of him right there. So his comments escaped. So, but don't worry, take care of that. You know, they are Asians. They are Asian trolls, BOT or bots. They are everywhere. And since the broadcast is public, we'll get rid of them after the show. Assuming I'm using another device, I would have got that taken care of. So now let's round this up. Let's round this up quickly. My message tonight is not to attack your religion. So we have said all this. And now let's talk to ourselves, okay? My broadcast tonight is not to attack your religion. Your belief is yours. And nobody has any right to judge you for it. But we have a very complex situation in Nigeria right now. And the complex situation is this. As complex as religion is, so is politics. And the representative of the religious bodies, they are people we called Eniowo, men of honor, Eniowo. And if most of them have forgot what they represent, it is always better for people like you who value your religion and will never never take it from anyone that talks down, at you based on this. But we have a problem, like I said. Your pastors are meddling in our politics. If they want to join politics, let them join politics. And we will stop seeing them as pastors. We'll start treating them as politicians. One of your pastors joined politics and he became vice president of Nigeria. The day he swore the oath to be the vice president of Nigeria, the day he ceased to be a pastor. Even though your Bible may say something different, but because I don't want to judge your religion, I want to talk about the man we are paying money. We've given him a house. We are the one feeding his family. Some will say, well, he's been feeding his family before now. Na lie. It is only when he joined politics and he became the Attorney General of Lagos State under Tinubu as a public servant. Since then, he's been enjoying public money, public goodies. So if you see him in church, you can call him a pastor. But to people like us, he's the vice president of Nigeria. And you cannot be vice president of Nigeria except you are a politician or you are a military officer that plan coup. A pastor can never be the president of Nigeria because he's a pastor of a church. No, he won't be. He will be a pastor. I mean, he will be a public official through election only if he's a politician. And you can say he's a pastor, he's not a politician. Some of you can deceive yourself. But you tell your pastors, tell your imam, tell your alajis, tell all of them that we are tired of that God they have been threatening us with. They have been threatening us with over time. Telling us that one God will destroy us if we ask them to do the right thing. Telling us that God will kill us or God will blind us, ruin our business, ruin our ruin our relationship and the rest of that. That is the only thing they are telling you that your God can do. But my sister, the real God that creates you, the God that brought you here, like those, I'm going to talk to you now like someone who really believes in God. I'm differentiating it for you now. You see, that God that brought you to this world, no be two, now one,
And the same one brought me. So now we are here. Whatever we do here, we are responsible for it. Not that God, though. Me and you, now we responsible for whatever we do. So in this regard, if you take public office, don't bring God with it. Do you get that? So tell your pastors to stay away from our politics. Tell your pastors to stop deceiving us. Tell your imam to stop dividing us. The religion you worship goes to one, what do you call it? One being, and that's the God, isn't it? How it gets there is your business. How my whole gets there is my business. Help us tell your pastors. The moment they start talking about our politics, we will start talking about them. And there is nothing that you or them can do. The only thing you can do is to resort to violence. Your Jesus was not violent. Jesus was never violent. I'm violent. But many of you will beat anybody up today because your pastor cannot command the person possibly to just go into coma. You know, when you have power, so they say the anointing that man is carrying, man, is so powerful. We appreciate your anointing. We appreciate the one you are carrying, and we appreciate the one you are putting in the bank. We appreciate the one you are flying, and we appreciate the one you are driving. All your anointing, we thank God for you. Stay away from our politics. Tell your pastors, stay away from Nigeria politics. The moment you start talking about the politics, we will start trolling you as well. Start knowing what and what you are doing. And the moment you start coming up with this, your prophecy, God told you this, God told you that. Wahala go happen. And when the wahala starts, now this kind of insult, you go, they see you. Your anointing is over those who are believing you. Your powerful, spiritual, whatever nonsense people are attaching to you, can only work on the morons you are manipulating. But for the good pastors, because we can't keep talking about the bad ones who are making things a hell for us. Good pastors don't get money. They are not rich. If you want to know good pastors, go to some of these CAC churches, like properly. It's just that I don't know what they are today anymore because everything is like upside down. But when we were growing up, we know what a church, you know, church is like a refuge place, to the point that our mother started believing that they should deliver in church. Not because of just only water and prayer alone. It's because in the church, they will take care of you. They will attend to you. They will respect you even more than what the local clinic will do, especially for those of us who never had money to go to private hospitals whenever we want to have our babies. That is how much churches at that time were to us. I attended Kirubu and Seraphim. I attended Sele. I attended CAC. I attended the St. Paul Church. I attended the Four Square Church. When the Pentecostal started coming, I became born again because they say you have to be born again. And I tried to be born again and I was doing the right thing. You know, I wasn't hurting anybody. But you know, they were always asking for more. You have to do this more. You have to do that more. It's always like you have not done enough. They say you don't pray enough. You don't. Allah, there is no time for all of this. There's so many other things we can do to better the life of humanity. So I opted out. But I have to commend those who are still there. It's a very beautiful experience for those who want to live within that confinement. And, you know, it's good for them. You know, born again, you know, Christianity, Islam, and the rest of that, whatever, all the teachings, the beautiful ones, and, the, you know, there is no problem. Do your thing. But respect others around you. Respect those who are not interested. And if you are in position of authority, protect all of us. Please, don't be all of us. Get that dream. Say we won't go live for one ever. And you must accept the reality. Whether you believe that your religion says, if I don't believe that, I'm going to hell. Now your hell? Don't be your own hell now. Leave us out of this. We, that knows that the only hellfire that exists, if there is any, is in Nigeria. That's the only hellfire existing. So if your religion, as powerful as you believe in it, cannot go to Abuja and tell Buhari that, Buhari, we are tired. Now pack your bag, jump into the next available Danfo. When you get to Katsina, turn right to Daura. When you get to Daura, I'll tell you what to do. Can't your Holy Spirit go and say that?
They say, oh, you are trying to study, you are trying to ask God his question. Allah, you live story, all that manipulation, all that sweet word, all that cajoling, all that distraction, all those things. We know her. We know her. When we want to talk to God, we will talk to God and he listened to us. When I wanted to talk to my God, you know, I told him, I want to go to UK with God. And I want you to make it happen because I'm going to start the process of my visa.
I didn't go to church to pray.
I just went online to check for what it would take to get me the UK visa. I went online, I checked everything, and you know, tried to find the ones I could get myself. I tried to get those who could give me orders that I didn't have. And when I finished, when I packaged the whole thing, and I was like, okay, now we have to go and tell God though, that I've packaged everything now. Everything they say I should bring to get UK visa, I have put everything together. Now, God, I'm going to submit it now. Eh? If it is your will, let this come to pass. I will go UK.
That's how me I pray. I'm a very this kind of a funny guy. That's why when you bring religion to me to come and try to blackmail me with religion and other nonsense, I throw it at you straight away and tell you to go to hell with your religion. Go to hell with your religion. Who cares about what you believe in? Who cares? You know? Who cares? Some of us have studied what it takes to acquire power. Just like those who are currently holding power and those who have held power in the past. So obtain power is a process. And only a foolish person believes that you just have to go and do something and pray somewhere. Then somewhere, something will just come and fall on you. It's not like that. In Ogun State, where I come from, I love to retract and then use as example. We told the young people there, and we said, let us all come together. It's not because we have any physical power compared to these criminals in government, but let us come together and see how many of us can build a force that can challenge the status quo politically without having to use religion, use every other divisive mechanism like all those criminals are used to, those babas. We told them, guess what happened? Because some of them have been so brainwashed through school, religion, churches, mosques, and the rest of that, they decided to go and open fake account. Hopeless human beings. We call them. Come here. Come. We have the number. We know how these people always do their thing. We know what they do. And the reason why it always works so fast and well is because they have the stolen money they can put people together. Right? Today, in Ogun State, you will see them everywhere. The young people that are meant to also see this light and not be deceived by all the lies and machination of these criminals, because I love calling them criminals. Guess what? They are more interested in us, in failing, than succeeding, so that they
or probably see through the fact that in succeeding, in us being successful, lies their own success. Ogun State, they have put themselves in different camps, looking for what to eat, and they will come back. They will say, stop attacking Christians, you cannot win election. Stop attacking Muslims, you cannot win election. But they are killing Muslims, they are killing Christians, left, right, and center, and the rest of them who are not being killed violently are being killed silently by hunger. In Ogun State, my state, hunger that they are repackaging. They are more, the young people, they are very few, because that's how it all started. We were telling them, like I'm saying my own now, and you know, they are more interested in us failing than succeed for them to be liberated as well. Join us, team up with us, and do something significant that we, this young generation, can at least say we try. My brother, we try. Assuming we've tried this long time ago, probably would have been better. But we tried. You know, the young people came together. They are opening fake account everywhere, abusing Badiru. Some are even like they are waiting because they want that thing to fail. And guess what? They want it to fail so that those criminals they call leaders, Obasanjo, Amusu, Gbenga Daniel, Buruji Kashamu, the drug baron. Do you get that now? They want them to succeed, just like many other Yoruba morons who say they are supporting Buhari because they are Christians. Look at that. They are supporting Buhari because they are Muslims. They are not supporting Buhari because we now have 24-hour power supply. They are not supporting Buhari because no political office holder is now traveling abroad for treatment. They are not supporting Buhari because now we have more children in school and we have built more schools because he has built more schools. No, they are not supporting him because of that. They are not supporting Buhari because finally we now have $1 to $1. No, they are not. They are not supporting Buhari because, the man has embarked on, you know, mass housing project that will soon give like 40 million Nigerians, you know, new homes. They are not supporting him for that. They are supporting him because they see many people criticizing Buhari as either Christians or Muslims who are genuine enemies. They want to see everybody as enemy and friend. That's the only way they want to see. It's not about the success of the man. Do you get that now? I see that people want to call me and it's just going to keep me here forever. I'm tired now. We'll do the phone call tomorrow. I'm not working until afternoon tomorrow. So we'll do phone call tomorrow. Do you get that now? So please, I won't take any call now or after. We'll take calls tomorrow. Can you get that now? Olabisi Alamu, you are lucky. You call me, you say I'm foolish. You are so lucky that I'm using my laptop. That would have been your last comment. Ask others like you, the idiots like you. Ask them. Some of you will come here and think, you want to come and do your politically correct nonsense. Do you know what I mean? You want to do your politically correct. I wish that's not for me anyway, but if that's for me, Olabisi Alamu, you will know that I'm not foolish, but you are lucky that we are using the laptop. You know what I mean now. I know there have been so many abusive comments in the comment section. We take them all the time. Sometimes if I want to reply them, I reply them just to make other people who are on this page. Do you get that now? Some other people who are on this page who are doing politically correct. You know, they love politics, you know, Yorubas, especially we Yorubas, we love to be politically correct. We love it. We love it. We're always like, no, don't abuse that. You can still present you can still make your point without abusing people. You see, we love it, Yorubas. But let me be honest with you. You see, all those who are trying to be politically correct, they are the morons I'm talking about. They are educated. You know what I mean? They will come here and say, you know, you are a blogger, so you need to have a, you need to be professional. Professional kill you there. Do you get that now? You need to be diplomatic. Diplomacy kill you, Dano. On my ego's diary, we don't get cussy. So if you are, someone asked me and he said, you need to learn how to, you need to learn how to behave when you are in the midst of elite. I said, I'm not elite. I'm a thug. Where would I learn elitism? I mean, what do you call elitism for? What is it called? Every Nigerian in Nigeria is a product of this thuggery and toutish system that many of us are living to deny. You will see your senator is a criminal. He moves about with criminals. They carry guns and order to protect him, like they are protecting the criminals in order not to escape. All your leaders are criminals, whether they are in PDP, APC, APGA, or wherever they are, including your religious leaders. Many of them are now criminals. They walk about with police are carrying guns to protect your pastors. Guns. Like they are criminals, they don't want to escape. They don't, you know, in America, where you see people carry gun after someone, he's a criminal. They don't want him to escape. So your leaders are criminals. So we are product of that system. So where are you getting this fake elite from? Elite. You need to talk like elite. You need to talk like a professional. Which professional? Professional of what? Of lying. To come and lie to you. Package jam. I want to sound porch. So you get that now. My Eagles Diary is a platform whereby we say the way it is. Whether it suits what you want to hear or read, it no matter. Whether it no suitan, it no matter. But you are lucky. You can abuse me. You can say whatever you want to say there. They say, you don't say that, you will lose your followers. Forget it. My followers will never leave My Eagles Diary. Others are guests. Yeah. When you see Buhari supporter on My Eagles Diary, he's a guest. Yeah. When you see a PDP supporter on My Eagles Diary, he's a guest. Yeah. Because what we do here does not support the two. So if you are here as a PDP member, you are just a guest. You are not my follower. I know my follower. I don't have 400,000 followers. But I know I have thousands of followers. So when you see 400,000 on My Eagles Diary, that's just, many of them are guests. That is why we see someone who joined My Eagles Diary to watch movie, free movie. Then all of a sudden, you just realize that someone is calling Buhari idiot. You say, who is this blogger? You don't even have etiquette of blogging. You the craze. Craze, day your head. Craze, day your head. Your politically correct madness can stay anywhere. On My Eagles Diary, we dey talk on the way it is. And we dey wait for the consequence. That's one thing many of you don't have. When you commit something or when you do something, you always love to be protected by someone somewhere who has the power to protect you. We don't have anybody anywhere to protect us. We can protect ourselves. We can fight for ourselves. We know the consequence of most of these things, and we are prepared. So if you are a guest on My Eagles Diary, that you are following My Eagles Diary doesn't make you my follower. I am the My Eagles Diary. When you hear My Eagles Diary, this is My Eagle. There is no other My Eagle anywhere. This is My Eagle himself. And what you hear from my mouth, it's like you hear it from the oracle's mouth, direct. Don't twist it. Don't use political correctness to make it look somehow. I no get culture for criminals. I no get courtesy for them. I can use any word, any language. I can say whatever I want to say. The words that will come is, they will come for me. And when they come for me, na me then go meet. No be you. And that's where you see my followers, my real followers, my Eagles Diary followers, you know, the real ones. Those ones will stand up. You know what I mean? So you've made us feel so bad about the whole thing. You know, genuinely, you've made us feel so bad and so, you've made us feel so blackmailed. It's terrible. When we want to talk about the vices in our society and all that, then you start doing this, your classification, and you start threatening us. Start threatening us with your Holy Spirit, your this, your that. Holy Spirit, kill you down. So we don't get cussy here. If you're a guest here and you're watching me for the first time, the only thing I won't do is to come on this screen not wearing clothes. I can wear anything that is comfortable. You know why? Because we know they do class here. That's what we want to fight and destroy. We don't want to do religious supremacy and all that nonsense that is in your head. All of you that are now currently becoming Afa. Some of you are now becoming pastor. You. Not today. When we were going to the Quranic school to study Quran, we were not studying Quran to be Afa. We were studying Quran to know God. How to worship and pray to God. How to be just and, you know, to do the right thing. But you mad people, today you'll be everywhere threatening people with this, your small tiras. That you can do, or this your small on twos that you can do, all the ones that you can do and make someone not to sell a market, all that nonsense you can do and make one girl that you cannot even talk to, you go and use that and bring her to you know, to your room, and they possibly manipulate them with all this nonsense. No triumph with me. I dey here. We know the consequence of everything. We know be pikin. We know be children. Some of you are grown. You have this grown up this adult body. But guess what? Trapped in that body is a very little man, very little woman, very little man who's lost his own self-esteem. And he believed that religion will give it back to him. If you lose your self-esteem, religion cannot give you. They say, pray to God, pray to Jesus to uphold you. Forget it. All nonsense. You have to uphold to yourself. You have to stand up and stop looking for someone to knock at your door because you are praying. To knock at your door and say, I heard your prayer. Nobody, all of us did that one, no. And if you want to do one for your house. Do one for your church. Don't bring your useless religion into your useless religious belief into our system. And cause confusion everywhere. Because look like, you know. And when we are ready to mobilize people to go and deal with these criminals, all your pastors will come from nowhere and say, hey, we must have peace in this country. What peace? What peace? Many people don't get peace. Someone is saying we must pray to have peace. You don't pray to have peace. You fight for peace. That is why we are buying guns for police. That is why we are buying guns for army. To protect us. That's why we didn't buy Bible for them. That's why we didn't buy Quran for them to go and defend Nigeria. We are buying guns for them. Fighter jets. We are buying them armor tanks to defend us. Some of you will come and say, hey, this country needs prayer. Keep your prayers. Because you can't pray to God to fix Nigeria. And those who are destroying Nigeria will come at night and you will lay your hand on them and bless them and say, Holy Spirit is with them. What Holy Spirit is that? What kind of fraud is this, for goodness sake? Stop threatening people online. If you have any view you want to share about this mixing politics with church, share and nothing will happen to you. You understand? Nothing. If anything happened to you, they don't write and say it will happen to you. But I'm going on the road now. If I fall on my bike, I pray that nothing happened to me. But if it happens, it's been programmed to happen. You get that now? It's been programmed. Let them stay away from our politics and we will not talk about them. Whatever they want to do in the church is the work of God. They should continue. Do you get that now? So this page, we set up My Ego's Diary to have a platform where we can at least express ourselves without the fear of maybe someone is going to get offended and then it's going to stop, possibly it's going to cancel my contract in their ministry and all that. I don't have contract with them. I don't have jobs with them. I've never worked for any of them. I've never been given any of that. I've never requested for any of that. Probably the time I should have requested for that was when I left Nigeria. So it has always been a plan that is completely different from what all those myopic, short-sighted morons following them all about. We'll never understand. People like us, we always set our own priority. We set it. Do you get that now? We always set our priorities. Okay, I want to go to the UK. Okay, what are you going to do in the UK? I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that for this year, for this year, for that year. After this so year, I'm going to get back onto it. You don't have a clue. Some of you say, oh, you opened the page to get money from Buhari. Buhari no get money to give people like us. It's as simple as that. Because whatever money that Buhari can give, they say state governors are earning 750,000 naira. I am richer than every state governor in Nigeria, if it's by salary. Do you know that now? Many of you are richer than your state governors, if it's by salary. But you know it's not about salary. And you accepted that. And you call them multimillionaires, big men, rich men. I am richer than all your governors. If it is their salary, 750,000 naira a month, I am richer than him. And I have friends who are far, 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 far richer than them. I have friends who, you know, God bless them. I have friends whose monthly take-home pay loan in this country is over, is over £2,000 after tax, after everything.
And they are Nigerians. They are any better than all your governors combined as in. But it's because of all these ceilings that you know, that I know, that Buhari is a rich man. Where? What did he get? Except for everything he stole from Nigeria, legally. Because when they took over power, they changed the law, they gave themselves retirement, they gave themselves health coverage, they gave themselves security coverage, they even gave themselves, what do you call it? Houses, that they must be getting different houses at some time. So if you want to talk to me and say people like us just talking and talking, it's because, and then you abuse people like us and defend those criminals in power. It's because you are one of them, and the brainwash and all that they've done on you. You understand now? It's still very much active and potent. Nigerians living outside Nigeria are better than your politicians if they are to be paid the genuine money, I mean the real money that is there in the constitution. But because all of you who are following them, you are not better than them. Lazy bums. Lazy, unproductive, useless miscreants who want the status quo to continue so that your free meal can continue. When you see them in PDP, sometimes it's not because they are already enjoying the free meal, but because of the slave mentality. I call them the humbled slaves. Some of them have jobs, but because they are slaves, mentally enslaved humans, humbled slaves, they still look up to all those criminals for survival. They have jobs, but their greed, their laziness will make them defend the criminals so that they can get something. And they are always here throwing it at all of us because it's Facebook. Everybody is okay. Everybody has to appear better. Facebook. So they will come here and start speaking English. They will start writing English. They will start quoting English. They will start telling us about economics. Start telling us about engineering. Start telling us about all these mad things that are only that only exist in their empty sawdust heads. You know, sawdust pack heads. I don't have respect for them. And I'm only saying this so that you know that that guy don't get courtesy. The guy don't get courtesy. Do you understand now? I don't have respect for Nigerian politicians. I don't. And I'm about to lose my respect for Nigerian pastors. And the moment I lose it completely, Alaye, na endless, oh. Now then you go wake that your Holy Spirit. Now then you go wake that your God and the anointing on top of all those crooks you call pastors. They will have to wake up their anointing then because they have to do something. And people like us, now people with God won't destroy, will fight us. Then God is ready to destroy you and just get rid of you like you are just a waste of space. Then you will fight us. We are fighting them in Ogun State right now. And we are trying to go through all the good pastors, the men of God who are preaching the word and who are not manipulating the the church. So then they're doing the right thing. We've got churches, we have mosques for a very long time until deep security people start taking over. So the people who are underrating us most are the youth. And don't blame them. In Ogun State, we have some of them in my state. I love talking about my state. That's a place, that's going to be the theater of political activity in 2019. You're going to see real feel like real politicking, championed by the youth. Where we're going to bring everybody out, everybody. And everybody's going to come under the same umbrella with no biasness of all this mad nonsense belief of I'm a Christian, I'm a Muslim, so therefore I cannot challenge my leaders. We'll challenge everybody in Ogun State. All of them. They can't even challenge us. And that's where the whole point is. They don't have the capacity to challenge us. You see, every other capacity they might they may be probably, you know, throwing about right now is because they have the power. Amosu is in government. People will have to rally around him. He's got the money. Remember, it's about the free money. And we have all these pastors going to Ogun State as well to go and organize concerts. They will organize state-sponsored concerts. They will bring Adeboye. They will bring Oyedepo. They will bring all of these people, Kumuyi. They will say they should come and preach to the Ogun State people. And all the thieves, the ones that just bought his house in Dubai, the one that just finished his house in Lekki, the one that just finished his beautiful hotel in VI, the one that just got this massive, brilliant, lovely hotel in Abuja, who sits there with people's money, the money they stole from Ogun State, buying everything, they will still steal there. I mean, sorry, they will still sit there. Adeboye will be blessing them. Adeboye will be praying for them. Adeboye will be telling them that they will succeed. How? How? How can they succeed? When Adeboye knows that they are thieves, some of them will go to Adeboye's church and pay tithe. Some of them will go to this, they will do church projects. With our money, these guys are not rich people. They don't have jobs. They don't have anything they are doing, but they throw our money about everywhere. They say, because I'm a governor. And some of you brainwash dead brain morons who are following them in APC and PDP will come and say, when you get there, don't do your own. Say, if it's you, won't you buy a car for your wife? Mad people everywhere. They are everywhere. Mad people everywhere. They don't like hearing it. But keep telling them. It is not because you want them to hear. It's because you want people to run from them. People need to start running from them. You can let someone who is a big shoko, who doesn't even know that he has mental problem, that he's suffering, and he doesn't even know he's suffering, and he wants to keep you perpetually stagnant like him or her, to continue the sufferness. That's madness. You understand now? So you cannot support Buhari, support Oshimbajo. Witness what is going on in Nigeria, and then now form a ring, form this kind of club, Moron People's Club, on social media, defending them because you are a Christian, because you are a Muslim. How else is madness symptom react, as in chose? Tell me. If it's not that, how else? Oh, you know? So you, my friends on my Ogun's Diary, my real friends, we no like them because they are supporting those who don't like us. And they are doing so. Some are doing deliberately for what they want to gain. Some are doing it ignorantly. Those who are doing it ignorantly are more than those who are doing it deliberately. You see all the political office holders who get to office, and suddenly they become multimillionaires. Those ones, those are the small ones who knows what they are doing. But they are doing it, that's why they are supporting that things must continue like this. Those are the ones they give, what do you call it, counselor. Those are the ones who claim to be youth. At the age of 60, they make them party youth leaders. They will defend anything, no? It is easy. But you know, easy, when people, when politicians, when they take all opportunities away, and they come, they throw them out small. You go see a 60-year-old man, I will tell you he's a youth. And he'll put out a poster and say, I'm contesting to be the youth leader. 60 years old in my state, Ogun State. APC youth leader in my state is 54 years old. Youth leader. And guess what? The youth themselves will say, we like him. That's how much they brainwash my people. The youth that you want to say, how can you accept that? You know, they don't brainwash everybody. Everybody, they hungry now. I say, don't mind that bad day. We go just sit down for that in a room. They talk. Now talk, we go shop. Those are the hungry ones you see on Facebook every now and then defending the nonsense. Because it's about shop. Make me shop. And it's so bad that they are now like seeing all of us as those who just want to shop. It's terrible. Just like the Canadian government is now like focusing on us coming to Canada. People whose only interest in politics is what they want to eat, they have managed to drag all of us into it now. Because they themselves are complaining because they are not eating. We are complaining because all of them are starving the whole country with our money. Our money, they put it in their pockets and starve the whole country. So those ones who know those who are stealing our money are fighting because they are not giving them. Now, they are now dragging all of us as if to say it's because they are not giving us money. Our money, eh? Our money. Imagine. Someone will stand up and say, I'm the governor. With what God has done for me, with what God has blessed me with, my children will never suffer. And a poor man who doesn't even know the reason why the governor is saying his generation will never suffer again, poor man who say, Baba, not true. What do you expect? Now, the guy is a governor now. I forget. Apart from money, where they pay him. The guy, money day now. And when you say, but you're not supposed to steal money now. See, now our money, they still say, my brother, I leave that one. If you get there, you don't go steal. Make them steal, but do something. How can you steal and still do something? How? You want to buy a bicycle, and it's going to cost you 100 naira. Eh? Then so you have the 100 naira. Then someone just came and steal 17 naira from it. And you say, but at least it's good. Let him just do something. And they say, now the 30 naira cannot buy a bicycle anymore. The 30 naira can only buy you a sander with very strong soles. The footwear. They say, it's the same thing, my brother. It's better than walking on BF. See, we were supposed to buy us bike. I know you're supposed to buy us bike. 100 naira. We were supposed to buy a bike. He stole 17 naira. What if he steal everything? What would you have done? There are people like that on social media that will ask that stupid question. Those are the ones that will say, my thief is better than your thief. They say, but he still try. What if he steal everything? What do you want to do? What do you go do? That's where the problem is. Something must be done. So that the one that steal today, when the one coming tomorrow, see what happened to the one that steal today, and he knows that he's coming to steal, he'll just tell you that, my brother, I'm not interested in politics again. I just lost interest. I just lost interest in politics. He will change his mind. But when you say that one that saw 200 naira and stole, or let's say, I'm still, 60 naira. You say, my brother, is still better. The guy only stole 60 naira. The guy only stole 60 naira. We still have 140. What if he had stole, the entire 200 naira? Because some of you even expect him to steal the whole 200 naira. So that we can now say he's a thief. My brother, you said no doing well now. Why you go steal the whole 200 naira? You should leave something for those who they come now. Wait till we could come steal. The people with this mentality are the most dangerous human beings that you must never be seen around. No matter how educated they are, no matter what public image they put out every now and then, be careful of them. They are the dangerous people that will do worse. And they will tell you to be careful of those who are condemning those criminals because they will do worse. No, not us that will do worse. They will do worse because these are the people that will tell you that, my brother, nobody will office to know. Even the state governor came to us and told us that a man cannot live by his earnings, monthly earnings alone. I've been living on my monthly earnings in the last 6 years, even when it was absolute nothing. I've been managing it. Because should I go and steal here now? And the police will come to my house and chop the door and say, come, we are arresting you for credit card fraud. You stole money worth 100,000 pounds. That is exactly what they are doing. And it doesn't make any sense. So we have spent so much time tonight. I enjoyed myself. I don't talk my own. Some will come, they say, we are too young for what we are doing. Some will come, they will say, we should be careful. But we have a message for you as well. Our message is this.
It's like many of you are not preparing for what is coming. You are just too confident that your leaders will fix things, that these young people are just wasting their time. It's not, they are, don't worry, they will crush them. So instead of you wanting us to be careful, is it not better you start preparing yourselves for what is coming? So that even when it's going to happen, your case won't be like that of PDP. I mean, those who remain the PDP when the new PDP decamped. Those ones were those who believed that with this instrument, we control INEC, we control army, we control police, we control. Do you get that now? Your case will be worse, so, because your own confidence is like zero. There's a say your you know, zero. There's something about zero. Remind me. I want to, because anyway, your own shock will be too devastating. No, Buhari cried in 2011. My brother, you go cry blood. Oh, you know why? PDP, those who remained in PDP in 2015, they never, in their widest imagination, that something could happen, and all of a sudden they will be out of power. You can look around now. Some will say, who is going to defeat Buhari? You don't worry. I remember I was one of those who said Buhari can never defeat Jonathan because Jonathan has a... I knew the weakness of Jonathan then. But we believe that, oh, he's going to use the instrument of the state. But well, let's thank God that he didn't. And some of you will believe that Buhari will use instrument of the state against the opposition like he's doing now, then he's going to win the election, then he's going to continue, he's going to have 8 years and the rest of that. Buhari himself has confessed. He said, the opposition seems to be much more powerful now. But when Buhari was saying that, he was referring to the dead PDP. PDP is dead. If PDP contests against APC in 2019, you didn't listen with me? I mean, you didn't listen to me? Without, or let's say with the campaign that is ongoing now, that is going to reduce and decimate both camps in 2019. You get that? If PDP stand against Buhari in 2019 with the current trend, they will lose. Buhari will lose. They will see who is going to form the government. And for the first time, like you saw it in 2015, something is going to happen in 2019 and it's going to be part of history again. So it is always better to prepare your mind this time around. Don't be too sure. Jonathan didn't do half of what PDP didn't do half of what Buhari is doing now in 3 years. You don't know the threat. They can cover it, they can package it for all of you. They can make it look like it's nothing. But the threat of what Buhari APC has brought upon our democracy, the threat is real. And everyone is worried, including those who once vouched for APC and Buhari. They are worried. But you can keep enjoying the momentum on your phone. You can keep enjoying the optimism, the pessimism, and every other drama that comes with all of this. The real players are worried. And I can tell you that confidently. The real players, including Buhari himself, are worried of what is coming. And maybe I should just tell you about a little bit about what happened, what transpired in Zimbabwe, when there was time for the people to genuinely challenge Mugabe. They brought Tsvangirai, or what's his name, is dead now. For the first time, the authority, the political capital of Robert Mugabe, was challenged. And they had to start something called national power sharing arrangement. So if you're a young person involved in this movement to orientate, to enlighten the Nigerians not to go with this old wagon, it's going to be a win-win situation for us in 2019 if we continue to push. The Take It Back movement are doing wonderfully well, that we must commend them. We must commend them.
Same with Fela Drotoye's team. They may not be as loud as Take It Back, but they are part of it. They are part of the equation. They are part of the puzzle towards 2019. So now let's see how much they can try between now and December 2018. So something is going to happen. It's going to be a win-win situation for the young people of Nigeria and for the old people who are young at heart, who want to see things done differently. So you see, when they say Buhari is not going to win election in 2019, all the politicians in Nigeria are going to lose their relevance. They're going to lose some of their influence. Influence the area. They're going to lose their influence in some part of Nigeria in 2019. So when we say they are going to lose, some of you are waiting for something different. Probably someone will replace Buhari, and it's just going to be like that. We will force it. We will push the campaign to the point that something that has never happened in Nigeria history, political history before, will happen in 2019, peacefully, not violent, because there are those threatening. When you talk, they threaten you with incarceration, they threaten you with detention, they threaten you with death. We will not threaten them, but we will do our best to challenge the system, right? And in 2019, a new chapter is going to be opened in our history as a people. Thank you so much for your time this evening. Every time I want to leave, I keep coming back, and the rest of that is because you guys are still enjoying it and the rest. But this time around, this is going to be the last stop. Like I said, tomorrow, I've got half a day tomorrow. It's called half a day shift. So which means I can enjoy myself the way I want to, just like this. Go to bed late or whatever I want to do. It's the UK, man. This is UK. You choose what you want to do, and you are responsible for everything you choose. And that's exactly what we have to take back to Nigeria now. Nigerians must be responsible for every choice they make. And they must be taught how to be responsible for everything you choose and not blame anybody and say, it's because of you. It's because of you. It's because of you. Good Uwashuku. I don't know what you are talking about. We have some of you crackheads on My Ego's Diary. We have so many crackheads here sometimes. Is that they come here and tell you, what are you trying to say? On this page, I don't try. If you miss a word, just go back and watch the video. If I want to call anybody idiot, I call them idiot. If I want to call anybody stupid, I call them stupid and the rest of that. If I want to say something, I want to say it. So if you have any other contrary to it, you should just present it, or you should just go and, disappear. So whatever we say here, if anybody, let me be frank with you, if anyone feels or any politician feels like they have been smeared, or they have been I want to pick all these big names they always bring up to scare all of you when it comes to a small issue of, okay, you abuse me, it's because you abuse me. Libel, they call it libel. Defamation, they call it defamation. If you see anything that is defamatory about your name, about your person, about your whatever, alaye, don't shoot gun, go to court. That's how a normal society operates. Some of you are Boko Haram on social media. Like, if you get hold of someone who is talking about the people you love, you want to shoot them and all that. Alaye, don't shoot. If you feel offended, don't shoot. Go to court. If you take me to court, I'll come there, So that is how a normal society should act, And if you are fighting, if you are abusing my groom because of all these criminals, go and get your head checked. So all of you crackhead, APC crackhead on social media, the children of outside, and the children of Tramadol, is it Tramadol and Codeine, the generation of drug abusers, the people who brought all of that upon you are those we are talking about. So if you come on social media to abuse me, you are just abusing your gullibility. You know what I mean now? It's more or less like abusing your gullibility. Those who you think will save you or help you, they cannot help you, and they will never help you. Whether you're a Christian or a Muslim, they have nothing. When they are dealing in all of this nonsense, they don't consider anybody as a Muslim or a Christian. They don't even use it as a criteria. It's about one ideology of how to loot and kill. And until all of you who have been swindled, all of you who have been defrauded by that lie that lie of religion and the rest of that, you know. If you can't change, please take that your crackhead elsewhere. Take it elsewhere and don't infect people on this platform who wants to get the right information and then process it themselves and, you know, possibly make something out of it. My northern brothers, you are my brothers. I am not one of those that will say you are my enemy. We may not be really close. And I know why we are not. It's because of Buhari and APC. Some of you, you are doing that because, number one, it came from your region. And it's so unfortunate that your region is still the most impoverished region. Everything I am saying here is because I'm a Yoruba man, I'm an Ijebu man, and I'm a stakeholder in the project Nigeria. Buhari is the manager of that project. And that project, the management of that project is affecting me in Ijebu. We don't have power. We don't have roads. We don't have hospitals. Our youths don't have jobs. And if you face me and say, is it Buhari that will create jobs for them? It's because you don't have a clue about what a country and a government mean. Yes, Buhari must provide road. He must provide hospital. He must provide schools for my people in Ijebu. He must provide employment for our youth in Ijebu. But if from wherever you come from, if that doesn't matter to you, no problem. I am a stakeholder in Nigeria Project as an Ijebu man, as a Yoruba man, as a Nigerian. And if you have sold your own right to Buhari to decide for you, I have not sold mine. Do you get that now? So in this regard, he's mismanaging the project, Nigeria. Just like others have also mismanaged it. It's only that Buhari is coming to kill it and bury it. And we're happy that he's going to bury the establishment, not Nigeria. So before he finally bury Nigeria, please, let us see how much we can do to salvage our own problem. Salvage our own from the whole project, Ijebus and the Yorubas. So as an Ijebu man, you may come from Katsina, you may come from Bauchi, you may come from Adamawa. I've never been to Adamawa, I've never been to Bauchi. And same way some of you have never been to Ijebu, some of you have never been to Dogolu, some of you have never been to Ogun State, some of you have never been to Ota, you've never been to... Even within my Ijebu, you've never been to Ijebu Go Ago, you've never been to Ijebu Fe, you've never been to places that matter to us, where we have people that deserves government attention. And that also is Buhari's best friend. So if Buhari is paying you in the north, I'm from Ijebu, and I have every right to tell you that this manager must be sacked. Now we be stakeholder, and I'll be shareholder in the project Nigeria. You may have sold your own right, too. It's normal. It's normal. No, there's nothing bad in it. There are people who sell their equity in so many places when they are no longer like they don't value it anymore. It's normal. But me, I have not sold my own franchise, my own stake as a Nigerian to Buhari, Tinubu, Obasanjo, or the rest of them. And if you have sold yours, you better go and take it back now. That's the best thing. You know. So thank you so much, my sister, Majeko Dumi, Abimbola, and all of you. I'm sorry, we have almost 900 comments here. I can't read them. You understand? So thank you so much for your time, for staying up to be part of this. And it's actually 12 o'clock in the night, you know, midnight. That's fantastic. So thank you so much again for your time. And look into the message. Don't worry about me. I'm the messenger. You know what I mean? I'm the messenger. I'm not perfect. I'm just a vessel. They have used me to deliver the message. Look at the message. The one that you think off point, that you think these ones are off point. They are not useful. Discard them. The ones that are useful to you, pick them and work on them. It's going to be for your own good, not for me. You know what I mean now? So I live in the UK. I can afford my own plane ticket to Nigeria. I can afford to sleep in the best hotel in Nigeria. Your best hotel that they will charge me maybe 100,000 naira a night. I can work for that from here and sleep in your 100,000 naira a night hotel in Nigeria. Wear a mopole with gun
And I would just give 50,000. I say, but officer, how much is your salary? Say, my salary is 80,000 naira. I'll give you 200,000 naira. You will guide me for another two weeks. I will be going everywhere. I'll put him in a nice car, put AC on him. He will protect, at least act like he's protecting me. So I will sleep in hotels with a 24-hour power supply. You know what I mean? You know, I will meet my friends with the little money I will come home with. We'll drink, we'll gist, you know, I will do everything. I am not a victim anymore. I'm not a victim of the rot, the system some of you are trying to salvage in Nigeria. So the reason why I am doing all of this is because we have too many victims who can't speak for themselves or fight for themselves. So why not? Why can't we just be... When you say politicians are selfish, many of you are also selfish as well. You are supporting politicians who are selfish against the people they are oppressing and killing. They can't change their situation and, you know, come on. So when you see me on Mayegun's Diary, I'll not be one of those your political, what do you call it, your political jobbers, those who are looking for your political money. If any politicians bring money to me now, I used to say I'll reject it. If you bring money to me now, I will give them my party account, Green Party account. And when you give party money, you can't say you give Badero money. Because they don't have the money that will make someone like me, right, change my world and change my belief and change my position about how I see Nigeria after all I know. So that's why people like us are doing this. This platform is more or less like a non-profit until we commercialized it to pay the guys who are working behind the scene. Many of you don't even know. Mayegun's Diary pay people to work on this platform. We pay them salary that is more than your minimum wage in Nigeria. You have guys who work on this platform. They are Nigerians, young guys, who needs, you know, they need to keep their body and soul together. So instead of them joining politicians who are going to be using them and sending them to possibly to get killed, I pay salary on this platform. I don't think you know. Because some of you are just here with your Shinko phone to blab rubbish some of the time because you want to defend Buhari, you want to defend all of these people. We pay them. Now, Mayegun's Diary is a platform that is still going to expand by the special grace of God. It will expand and it will give more youth opportunity to, you know, to experiment, to practice their own, whatever talent they have. Something like this. I didn't go to school to be a journalist or anything. So therefore, it's of no use. You know, we have to grade everyone on that, you know. So we are doing our best to keep this platform as open and as clean as possible and as encouraging and inspiring as possible to people who want to get things done, not the rabble-rousers and the crumb-eaters who are more interested in the next clients. So thank you so much for your time. And until I see you again, don't stop following my ego's diary. And to those crackheads, you know, stop reporting my ego's diary. You know what I mean now. So let's do this together and liberate ourselves. The little we can do, every little help. Thank you so much. And you have a good night. I'll see you some other time. Ade Doyi, my sister. Good night, eh? And all this Indian commenting on Mayegun's Diary this night. It's like it is afternoon in India now. Or is it early morning in India? Whatever it is, we'll get rid of them. Thank you so much, and you have a good evening or good night.